Assalamu alaikum, myself Ehkam Ansari. Student, I am back again with yet another video lecture of information technology. We have started our third chapter, that is impressive web designing, in which we are working on client-side scripting, that is JavaScript. Okay, so let's have a look what we are going to learn in today's lecture. Our chapter is JavaScript, or our section is JavaScript, our chapter is impressive web designing. Okay, now in that particular topic, we will learn operators in JavaScript. So before we start, first I will tell you, JavaScript is a client-side scripting language and it is used to perform arithmetic operations and different logical operations, because it creates a dynamic web page. By using HTML only, we cannot perform arithmetic operations. So it is the advantage of JavaScript which creates or which make your web page dynamic, and by using JavaScript you can create static web page as well as you can perform arithmetic operations. Okay, so JavaScript is a very important language in calculation point of view, if you think, because by using HTML or CSS you can only design your web page, but if in case if you want to perform any arithmetic operation or logical operation, you need to have any scripting language. And one of the most famous and one of the most supported language for scripting or for client-side scripting is JavaScript. So we are working on JavaScript, and in which we are going to start a new topic, that is operators in JavaScript. So what is Java? What is operators? First, operator means what? The thing or the symbol which is used to perform certain operations. Okay, operators are nothing but certain symbol which is used to perform certain arithmetic operations. Okay, for example, if you want to perform addition, so you have two values, one is value x and one is value y. So you want to perform addition of these two values, but in between these two values you need to have certain symbol. That symbol decide what you are going to perform. Means for addition we have a special symbol, for multiplication we have a special symbol, for division we have a special symbol. So these symbols are called as a operators. Okay, so let's have a look what we have in JavaScript and what is the purpose and objective of these operators. So the first thing I just want to clear, that operators are the symbol, or operators are something which is used to perform arithmetic and logical operations. Okay, arithmetic means, if I say arithmetic, means we have n number of arithmetic operations, like addition also comes arithmetic, division, multiplication, subtraction. These are the some basic function of arithmetic operation, or these operations come under the category of arithmetic operation. Okay, so in the same way we have different operation like logical operation, means if you want to perform certain comparison, or we have to check logic, in that case we have certain different operators, that is called a logical operation. So operators can be categorized on the basis of their use. So we have three types of basic operators, that is arithmetic operators, okay, in which we will perform some mathematic or some certain calculation, and we have relational operators in which we will compare two values, okay, greater than, less than, less than, equal to. Okay, these operations will come under the category of relation. And then logical means it's a whether it's true, false. These will come inside the logical operator. So we have different operators which come under the category of these three operators or operations. Okay, now let's have move to our definition part. Okay, it's a simple definition I have written. Operators are used, what is the purpose or what is the objective of operators? Operators are used to perform arithmetic operation and logical operation. Operators that require one operand. Now this line is very important. Why? Because in examination there can be a question, that what is a unary operator and what is a binary operator. Unary means is a simple word, you can say unary means one or single. Okay, unary means single or one. And you have binary means two. As we know, computer language is a binary language, or all the computer supported only binary language. What does it mean by binary? Binary means two, where binary in computer language is called as 0 1, but here just try to say binary means two. Okay, binary means two. So operators that require one operands, So what is operands? Operands means, for example, if I give an example like, let me show you what is a operands and what is a operator. So I will start notepad just to tell you what is operand and what is operator. So if I write a equal to, let me start from where a equals to 100. Okay, I have written where a equal to 100, then I have written where b equal to 200. I just want to tell you here, okay, what is where is simply where is a keyword which is used to declare variable. Okay, I am using where. So what does it mean by where? Where is a keyword. Why keyword is written? Because it's a reserved word introduced by the JavaScript, which means the person who created, who invented JavaScript, it given a meaningful value to where, which means it is used to declare a variable. Okay, so this part is completed. Okay, then I will tell you the next part. What is a? A, what is a? A is, I am talking about this a. Okay, a is name of variable. Okay, so this one is finished. What is equal to? Equal to is a symbol. Okay, equal to is a symbol which is used to assign value. Okay, which is used to assign a value. Then what is 100? 100 is value. Assign to a. Okay, so this thing we have learned in our earlier lectures, but I just want to tell you what is operands. So here a is operands. What is a? Here a is operands. Here a is operand. Okay, then what is equal? Equal to is operator. Equal to, what is equal to? Equal to is operator. Getting? A is operand and what is equal to? Equal to is operator. So if I write, what is mean a unary operator? So this is unary operator. Why? Because it's have only one operands. Okay, if I say a equal to 100, in this expression it's hold only one operands, that is a. Okay, so it's called as a unary operand, unary operator. If I write something like that, if I write control C and control V, and instead of a, if I write b. Okay, now in this line I am using a plus b. Okay, I am using a plus b. Here what is plus? Plus is operator, but it's have two value, one is a and one is b. If an operator have two values, that is called as a binary operator. If and operators have only one operands, that is called unary operators. Getting? So let's move back to our PowerPoint presentation. Now just add the operators that require one operands. Operands are nothing but your name of variable. Okay, operands are nothing but your name of variable. It can have unary or binary. Okay, if it's hold two operands, it's called as a binary. If it's hold only one operator, it will call as a unary. Okay, now move back to our topics, that is, operators can be divided into three. One is arithmetic, one is relational, and one is logical. In today's lecture, our focus will be on arithmetic operators. Okay, we will see what is arithmetic operator. So, like in different language or mathematics or some scientific language, we use a number of the operators in number of the arithmetic or calculation, and we have some fixed operators like addition, multiplication, division. These things are also supported in JavaScript. So we'll see how it works in JavaScript. So arithmetic operators are used in mathematical expression in the same way that they are used in algebra. Okay, in JavaScript the objective, the purpose and the style is same. Only the thing is that you have to use by using JavaScript. So you have to use JavaScript syntax, and the purpose and the objective and the result is same in like in algebra. Means if you write a plus b in algebra, and if you assign the value for a is 40 and value for b is 4, and if you perform by using this operator, so the output will be 44 in algebra. In the same way, you have to write your syntax according to your JavaScript, and if you perform these two addition of these two number by using this symbol, the output will be same. So the objective and function is work as algebra, geometry or any mathematic. In the same way, JavaScript is also work. Okay, so these are five basic. I am using the basic because n number of the operators we have inside the arithmetic operation, but we will only focus on these five operator. The first one is this symbol. This operator is basically called as a addition. Okay, that is addition. So if you perform a plus b, for example, you have a as a 40 and b as a 4, your output will be 44, a plus b. Okay, in the same way we have second operator, that is the subtraction. Again, this thing we have done in your primary level, but we are going to learn our language from scratch. That's why it's a compulsory to know how we use these operators in JavaScript. Okay, in the same way, this asterisk value, this is called as the asterisk value or symbol, you can say, or star you can say, because in your computer you will find this symbol as a star. Sometimes it's called a star, sometimes it's called asterisk. So no problem, you can say anything, but this symbol is called as a multiplication. Okay, and the purpose on the result will be, as in mathematics, if you perform multiplication, you will get the compound of these two, means a into b, you will get 40 into 4, you will get output as a 160. In the same, this symbol, there is a forward slash, but this symbol is called as a division. In your mathematical or in your arithmetic operation, so if you write a divided by b, means a is 40 and b is 4, so 40 divided by 4, you will get the answer as a 10. So these four things you have learned from your primary level, but this is very important. Okay, in IT or in JavaScript, it's very important, because student or people think that this symbol is used for percentage. Yes, this symbol is called as a percent sign or percent symbol, but this is work as a modulus or mode. Okay, this symbol is called as this one. I am focusing more on the last one because these four are basic, these four are same as we use in from standard 1-2 till now, but this symbol is very important because this symbol we have used till now as a percentage. But in IT, I am talking about the whole IT, not only for JavaScript, if you learn any language. So this symbol is used as a percent, but in IT language or in JavaScript, this symbol is called as modulus. Okay, this is the percent symbol, but is called as a modulus, and it is used to calculate the remainder. It is used to calculate the remainder. I am again repeating, this symbol is called as a modulus in JavaScript, but the objective or the purpose of using this symbol is to calculate or to know the remainder of any expression. Means if you perform, if you write a mod b, the value of a is 40 and the value of b is 4, so 40 mod 4, you will get output as a 0, because we are not going to perform division. In division we get some value like 10, but in modulus we get remainder. Okay, so if you want to find remainder, we have to use this symbol, but if you want to find the division, you have to use this symbol. Getting? So I will show you this thing, especially I will show you this one, because these are the basic and these are the same as it is in other language, but this is very important. I will show you in coding. So I hope you could understand what we have learned yet now, but the only thing is that this symbol is very important. That is a percent symbol, but it's called as a modulus, and it is used to find the remainder, because if you are going to build any logic, this will work, and this is very important. I'm just saying this is very important, because people think that this is used for percentage, but it's not used for percentage in any IT or any computer language. Okay, so I'm going to do a simple practical or simple skill oriented practical on the basis of this arithmetic operation, okay, in which I will show you all these, but my focus will be on modulus only. So I'm going to open a notepad file, so I can use anyone, not this one. Okay, so I'm going to remove all these things, because I have to write inside the HTML. So the first thing is that I will write doc type. Okay, what is doc type? My doc type is HTML. Then I will add HTML tag, the first tag of HTML, and I will write closing HTML, the last tag of HTML page. Inside that, my first tag will be head tag, that is on top heading of your page, and the closing head tag. After that, I will write the one of the most important tag of HTML, that is a body tag, because all other tag will come inside that body tag, and all the content you want to display on your web browser, you have to write between these tag. So now we have created a structure of our HTML page, in which we have head tag and body tag, and all the other tags and content will come inside these body and closing body. Now I'm going to write one heading, that is a h1 and closing h1. So inside that I will write one message, that I will write arithmetic operators in JavaScript. Okay, arithmetic operators in JavaScript. So let me save this file. Currently it's saving in my computer desktop, so I will say not an issue. I will write as a operators.html. okay, I will save it. Now you will get that we have created this file. Let me double click on that. So arithmetic operators in JavaScript, this is coming because you have written inside your body tag, or inside your h1 tag. Okay, now I'm going to add operators. So now we have to add JavaScript. So student, if you remember that we can add JavaScript in your HTML page by using two ways. The first way, or the first thing, is that you can add inside the opening and closing head tag. Means you can add in head section, okay, like this. You can add the script language equals to JavaScript. Then you have to write closing script tag. Okay, this is the one way. Means you can add your script tag between opening and closing head tag, or even you can add, I am just clicking on Control A, inside the body tag. Okay, there are two ways to add your script language or your JavaScript inside the HTML tag. You can add inside the head tag, or you can add inside the body tag. Okay, now we have these two lines. Whatever you write between these two lines, means बिटवीन ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग स्क्रिप्ट टैग, ओके, बिटवीन ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग स्क्रिप्ट टैग, इफ यू राइट एनीथिंग इट विल कंसीडर्ड एज अ जावा स्क्रिप्ट कोड एंड यू नो जावा स्क्रिप्ट इज अ केस सेंसिटिव लैंग्वेज एंड इट्स अ डायनेमिक लैंग्वेज सो इट विल क्रिएट प्रॉब्लम इफ यू डू नॉट परफॉर्म अकॉर्डिंग टू लैंग्वेज सिंटेक्स और अकॉर्डिंग टू लैंग्वेज रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन ओके सो वी आर लर्निंग ऑपरेटर सो आई एम गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ सिंपल ऑपरेटर फॉर एग्जाम्पल वेर ए इक्वल्स टू फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम गोइंग टू राइट 50 वेर ए इक्वल टू 50 then I am going to declare one more variable where b equals to 5 okay now simply I just want to display these two lines let me save the file if you want to display these two line or these two value simply write document dot write okay what is document document is an object JavaScript is a object oriented programming many of the thing is written inside the object and document is an object which have certain method or function which name is write which is used to display something on browser what is something you want to display you have to write inside this bracket okay so document dot write means this object is used to perform some function which function you are going to use I am going to use write function belongs to document object and the function the objective or the purpose or the function of this write is to display something on your browser so what you want to display the value of a so you just simply put a okay so if you write a it will if you understood that you want to display the value of a okay let me show you the output the value of a is 50 now you have written document.write only so it will display only the value of a flip back to your browser when you refresh the page now you will see 50 okay let me zoom it okay this is your output now it's coming 50 okay now I am going to display the second one so I will simply copy it control c and I will just paste it control v now instead of a I will add b also okay now I will click on save now flip back to your browser now you will get one more value that is a 5 after this value see the first one is 50 and the second one is 5 if there is a question in your mind that sir I want to display the same then another value in next line it is coming on same value is same line so it's showing as a 5 not 5 so instead of that I want to display the second value inside the after this line so it's very simple okay just write after this just write document dot write okay after this line just write document dot write and inside that instead of writing just add one tag in double inverted comma in double inverted comma write br okay your IT teacher which teach you HTML have already told you that br tag is used to break the line in HTML okay in HTML br tag is used to break the line or this tag is used to assign new line okay so this content will display after that when your cursor when your interpreter or compiler move to this line says that you want to display an HTML tag and the what is the value of this that is a br and what is the purpose of br br tag is used to break the line or I just want to tell you a simple or a golden word regarding HTML and JavaScript please note it down if you want to display or if you want to use any HTML tag inside the JavaScript you have to use in this manner means you have to write document.write then inside bracket then inside double inverted comma you have to write your tag name are you getting my point for example I just want to tell you For example, if you want to display these value in heading tag, okay, if you want to display these value in heading, for example, let me see the effect of this one, then I will show you how can we use HTML inside the JavaScript. Now my first value is 50 and my second value is 5. Okay, now it's in second line or in new line. Why? Because after this value I have used one HTML tag, that is a BR tag. But if I am going to add HTML tag inside, because in initial I said between these two lines, that is between script tag and closing script tag, all the thing which you write, it will consider as a JavaScript. So if you write only BR tag, it will not work and it may create some error. So now I am going to add HTML. So JavaScript says, okay, you want to add HTML inside my code, so you have to use this method. Means you have to write document.write, then inside bracket you have to write your code. For example, if I want to add inside that, so I will write this type, okay, I will add h1 tag, I will add h1 tag, then I will add plus symbol, then after that I will add closing h1, okay, closing h1, and I will add plus symbol. Getting? Are you getting my point, student? What I have done in this line here, I am using h1 tag inside the JavaScript. This code is belongs to JavaScript, but here I am using HTML tag. So JavaScript say it's okay, you want to use HTML, you can use, but you have to use in my way, because right now you are in my code. Okay, so how to write HTML tag inside JavaScript? Just write document.write, in double unit comma you can put your HTML tag. So this is my HTML tag I have written inside the double unit comma, and again this is your closing h1 tag. So the effect will be on a tag, the effect will be on a tag, but you have to write this to symbol, because it will considered as a concatenation. Okay, so if I save the file, you will notice that the value of a will be little larger at compared to value of b. So let me save the file, flip back to your browser. Now see the value of a is little larger, because I have applied, okay, so you can apply your HTML inside your JavaScript. So right now my value become 50 and it's in bold. Okay, again, so I think you got the answer how we can use the HTML inside the JavaScript, and how we use BR tag, or how we can do break line inside the JavaScript. So this is the tag. Now back to our main focus, that is our JavaScript operators. Now I want to perform addition of these two number. Okay, I want to perform addition of these two number. So I want to declare one more variable, that is a var c. Okay, var c. So after that I will display the addition of these two. So inside c equal to a plus b I have written, but I have declared one more variable, that is a variable c, in which I have not assigned any value. These two variable have hold some value, a equal to 50, b equal to 5, but I have declared one more variable, that is a var c, where I have not assigned any value. Okay, so why I have not assigned? Because I want to store the value of a and value of b inside c. So I have written this formula. This is the basic formula of addition of any number. So you have to write c equal to a plus b. What is the c? C is the storage area where you will store some value. Which value you will store? The addition of these two, a plus b. Or simply, if you don't want to perform any addition, or if you don't want to take the third variable, you can perform addition too. So just write, I am going to add this line again, so you will get the answer on your new line. Okay, control V I have given. Now I want to perform addition of these two number. I will write document.write. You want to perform addition, so simply a plus b. Okay, document.write a plus b. Means what is the value of a? A is a 50. What is the value of b? Is a 5. Now you will get, if you write a plus b, you will get the answer. Okay, let me show the, this is the first value a and this is the second value b. When I refresh, you will get the output. That is a 5 plus 5 is 55. 5 plus 5 is 55. Okay, now it's performing your, the first operator, that's your addition. Okay, now change your value to subtraction. Now if you remove this, and instead of this, if you add minus symbol. Okay, you have added minus symbol. Now click on save. Now you will get output. Instead of that, 50 minus 5, your output will be 45. Okay, now your output is 45. In the same way, if we go and use the multiplication, that is the asterisk. Okay, click on save and flip back to your browser, refresh. Now you will get 550 into 5, you will get output as a 250. Okay, in the same way, I am going to add division. So what is the use, what is the symbol? That is a forward slash is used for division. A divided by B. So I will save it. When you make any changes, please save it. Now you will get output result as a 10. 50 divided by 5, you will get result as a 10. Now student, if even you are not focusing, please pay attention over here, because we are moving towards what we are going to started, or main focus was on our modulus or mode. Okay, so if you write a mode, okay, a mode b, a mode b, what is your answer? If I write a divided by b, the output was 10. 5 tens of 50. Okay, 5 tens of 50. But if you use a mode b, means you are going to calculate the remainder, so the remainder will be 0. What is the remainder? Remainder means the remaining value which is not, which cannot be divided. Are you getting my point? What is mean the remainder? Remainder means the remaining value which cannot be divided. Okay, so if you write 5 mod 50, so 5 ones of 5 and 5 tens of 50, so this value or this number is completely divided by 5, so the remainder is 0. The remainder is 0. Let me show the output. Okay, now you will get remainder as a 0. Okay, remainder you are getting as a 0. Okay, but if you change the value, for example, instead of 50, I said it's a 51. It's a 51. So let me save the file. Okay, 51. Now if you see, if you divide this value by 5, so the 5 tens are 50, but remainder will be 1. Remainder will be 1. Okay, now you will get remainder as a 1. Getting? So by using this symbol, that is a modulus symbol, you will get remainder. Okay, hope you could understand what we have learned today. If you have any query related to operators in JavaScript or operators, right now we have just seen arithmetic operators. So if you have any query, please feel free to ask. Keep watching, keep learning. Many videos or many lectures on JavaScript to be come in future. Please stay tuned with this channel. Allah Hafiz.